In this video, I'm gonna give you a quick overview on Google Analytics, what it exactly is, how it can help you as a marketer, and why you should be using it, all and more coming up right after this. Alright, so you have built a website and now you wanna get as many visitors to view your content, read your blog post, or buy your product. Well, you probably heard of Facebook ads, Google AdWords, SEO, Pinterest, and more. But before you get started on this, let me ask you this. How do you actually know how many visitors came to your website? Where did they come from? And what did they actually do on your website? This is where Google Analytics comes in. Google Analytics helps you measure, report, and analyze the behavior of the user coming to your website. Now let's take a look at how it does that. First up, the measurement part. When you install Google Analytics, you will receive a tracking code that you need to place on your website, and we'll learn all about this in the next lesson. But once you have done that, from then on forward, every time somebody goes to your website, this tracking code will send information to Google Analytics. Data like which page is the user currently on, what browser is the user using, what are the language settings of his browser, what was the previous page that the user was visiting before he came to that website, and many other data points that Google Analytics actually measures. This all happens in the background through a technology called JavaScript. So the user itself doesn't actually notice anything when they visit your website. And then in Google Analytics itself, the data actually gets recorded and stored, and we can then see who is currently on our website. Now, once we have a few more people tracked that way, we can actually go to the second step, which is the reporting. Now, Google Analytics builds many reports from the data we have measured. In the interface, they are divided in the audience report. So you can find out more about the technology that your users are using, where they're from, and so on. And then the acquisition reports, where you can find out where the user came from that visited your website. The behavior reports, where we can find out what the user did on our website, which pages he visited, and which interactions he took on our website. And then the conversion report, which is all about, did the user actually take the action that you desired him to take on your website? Now, all of these reports are built and get filled automatically by Google Analytics, but you can obviously also build your own custom reports within the interface, which we won't get into right now, but it's definitely possible. Now, all of these reports don't do anything for you unless we start looking at them in detail, which brings us to our third step, the actual analysis part. And this is all about answering your questions with available data. Where did the user come from? Well, let's go into the acquisition report and find out. So here we see that most of the people come through the organic search results of Google. Now, obviously you might have further questions like, how does that compare to last week? Where did the user actually land on my website? And Google Analytics actually gives us many different tools to dig deeper into that data. We can filter our data, break it down further, visualize it differently, compare it, segment it, and many more different techniques that are available within the tool to do a quick analysis. The ultimate goal of your analysis is to get to insights and then to action. So once you have found something out, I would recommend to get to a conclusion, to recommend stuff to your boss, for example, or take an action upon your data. So for example, start an A/B test or change your website around. All right, so there you have it. This is really what Google Analytics is all about. It's quite useful to measure, report, and analyze your website visitors' behavior. Now, as you probably know, Google Analytics is by no means the only web analytics solution out there, but currently the most popular one, because it's free and it has been around for over a decade now, gives you a lot of capabilities to actually analyze your data, which are mostly found in paid tools as well. And it actually has become the de facto standard. So if you want to compare any data to another website who has also Google Analytics running, then you could do this easily because the view on the data is the same with this tool of Google Analytics. And a lot of people and a lot of websites have it installed nowadays. All right, I leave you with this little introduction to Google Analytics. If you want to install Google Analytics, then go over to our next lesson where we're gonna find out how to install Google Analytics correctly. And there are many more videos coming out in the series, so be sure to follow along, subscribe to our channel, because we're bringing you new videos just like this every week. Now, my name is Julian. See you in the next lesson.